Well, to Australian politics now, and the Treasurer has given his strongest hint yet that Tuesday's budget will include measures to drop the skyrocketing cost of fuel. A cut to the 44 cents a litre fuel excise tax is on the cards, which will save the average motorist about $5 at the bowser.
For many families, this is not a choice. They need their car to get to and from work. These are costs that families are incurring, and of course it's putting real pressure on the household.
It is the latest in a big week of spending announcements, including billions of dollars on big infrastructure projects and $365 million on trade apprenticeships. But Labor says the government is still failing to address wage stagnation.
The living pressures faced by Australian families didn't show up when Russia invaded Ukraine. They showed up when the coalition attacked wages and take-home pay.
Well, Guardian political reporter Amy Remeikis is here to give us her take. Amy, we know there's likely to be a cut to the fuel excise tax. There's also talk of cash payments for many. Are these just sort of little fixes to get the government through an election?
Well, I'm not sure if Josh Frydenberg would call them little fixes, given that it's his budget and he likes to think that everything is major and it's the greatest economic plan that we've ever seen. But it is absolutely shaping up to be a pre-election budget. The government is preparing its election war chest. It wants to go to the polls with a good news story, and it's going to do that through the budget, which we'll hear about on Tuesday.
There's been obviously a Royal Commission into aged care, which was incredibly shocking, a Royal Commission into disability, which has been equally shocking. How are they going to address those long-term issues?
Well, they've been attempting to address them before this budget has begun being spoken about. There was $17 billion in the last budget for aged care, which was meant to be spread out over 5 years. There's been promised one-off payments for aged care workers. We're also seeing the same sort of movement in disability care, although it does have to be said that there are people within the NDIS sector who are saying that the NDIS is going to be cut. Ultimately, this is not something that you can fix in the short term. This is something that needs somebody to have a huge look over it and go, where are we putting the money and how do we fix this? And you're going to need a lot more than a couple of lines in a speech to do that.
Amy, as we go through the budget papers, are we going to see the new generation of car park rorts, of sports rorts, or is there the remote chance the government has learnt a lesson over that kind of pork barrelling?
Well, given that one of the things we have been speaking about for the last 3 years, apart from COVID, has been spreadsheets and who's getting what money in which electorate, I don't think the government is going to be quite as open with their funding for marginal and Liberal seats this time around. But as John Alexander, a former Liberal MP, has said, it shouldn't happen. He's absolutely right. People are sick of seeing this sort of stuff. They just want money to go where it's supposed to go.
And so what we see is we sometimes see in the budget the little phrase that says money for decisions made but not yet announced. In other words, the things that they're going to drop onto the voting public between now and election day. Is that going to be a feature in this somewhere?
That absolutely will be a feature. And as you would know, having looked at budgets previously, it's never anything that's advertised. It's something that you've got to look in the small print. So there's going to be a lot of journalists out with magnifying glasses on Tuesday having a look for exactly how much money the government has committed to spending but is not saying what it's going to spend it on just yet.
Well, get those magnifying glasses ready, people. Amy Remeikis, great chatting with you tonight.